long trail of white thread. It begins in my mother's hand, and it trails down the road and through the town and out by the field and into the next town and on and on. And still, it does not stop. I picture it following me for days, going everywhere I go, unwinding longer and longer, its other end still tight in my mother's fist. I find her sitting by the stove in the kitchen, her back to me, her head bent towards her chest. Well, she must be sleeping. Hello? For a moment, I stand there and simply watch her from behind. My mother, with eyes in the back of her head. I am sure she knows I am there. And so I wait for her to turn, but a minute passes, and then another. And she does not move. Hello? I repeat. The only word I remember how to say. I walk in front of the chair to where she can see me. My mother looks up with her mossy eyes, and for a moment everything inside me drops to my feet, and I am empty and calling, a girl again, and then a baby, and then an infant, sounding out a long, fierce howl. And then my pieces come back to me. I am visiting my mother, and years have passed. Thank you. and her voice is not the one I remember. She looks up at me, vacant, like a vessel slowly leaking her contents. It's me, Mom, your only daughter. You know, the one you told your stories to. The one whose name you pick. The one who you heap rage upon rage. The one whose birthday you always forget. And I start to cry, wordlessly sitting there at my mother's feet. I cry because she does not know me, and years have passed. Because I can explain nothing now, mend nothing, because she has lost her quickness, her vivid, lovely mind, her urgent creativity, with its stories and her art and all her buried yearnings. I draw close and smell the lemon scent of her hair. And for a moment, I'm almost sure she sees me. Say my name, I think. Please, say it now.
When I look back, I picture the journey marked by a long trail of white thread.
And then she has lifted her hand and placed it on my hip. My mother, after all these years, I cannot tell if she knows that I am me, but her hand is the hand I remember. And I stay there trying not to move. She strokes my head up and down, back and forth. She touches my brow, my eyelids, pauses her fingers for a moment on my damp cheeks. But I am no longer crying or spinning backwards. And then she stops, and I peek into her eyes. I stare into her empty eyes. Mama. Mama. And then, for a moment, I am sure she sees me. Say my name, Mama. Please, say it now. Remember me, Mama. Please, remember me.